Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry. I want to thank Cricut for sponsoring this video. Halloween is around the corner and it may look a little bit different this year. You might be having a neighborhood trunk or treat or an online costume contest with friends or classmates, or your office might be having a small dress up the Friday before Halloween. In this video, I'm going to show you an easy DIY Halloween costume using the Cricut Explore Air 2 and the Easy Press 2. I'll be using the Cricut Everyday Iron-On to make the Seven Dwarfs. I want to thank Natalie A for suggesting it in my YouTube community, and make sure to check out the description box below. I'll put the links to all the products there. These are the items you're going to need. Seven different colored t-shirts or long sleeve shirts. You can get these at any craft store or big box store. I prefer to get a neon green for Dopey because that's more recognizable. And then I got yellow for Doc, teal for Happy, red for Grumpy, purple for Sleepy, green for Sneezy, and maroon for Bashful. Cricut Everyday Iron-On. I got black for the belt, gold for the buckle, and brown for the buttons. This I just used half, this about 1.5, and these about almost 2 rolls. The Cricut Explore Air 2. I love this color. They do have other colors. I have it here in my crafting area. Easy Press 2, I have the 9x9, and then the Easy Press Matte. The Easy Press 2 comes with this stand, which is fantastic, especially if you're using a table, and then it also comes with a bag. Strong Grip Mat, the portable trimmer, scissors, and the weeding tool. For the hats, I got different colored felt, as you can see here, and for the ears, I wanted to get a light colored felt, like a tan, and I just freehand drew these ears. For the beard, I got a template from the internet and twisted together 2 pipe cleaners and glued it to the back with a glue gun and glue sticks. You'll also need the glue gun to attach the ears and to attach the hats on the side because these are 2 pieces of felt. In Cricut Design Space, I made 3 different projects, Seven Dwarfs belt, buckle, and buttons. In the Seven Dwarfs belt, I just used a square and made it 11.5 by 3 inches. You go to shapes here, add a square. And the reason for that is that it's going to cut 11.5 for the mat that I have. And so I just copied another one and made this 6.5 inches because that's the width of the t-shirt. So it's going to print, or it's going to cut these two in the Explore Air 2. I ironed on the longer one first and then add the second one. And the good thing is that the buckle covers this part here. I mean, it's not noticeable, but it's just a bonus that the buckle covered that section. And then for the buckle part, again, I used the square shape and made it into a small 4 thinner rectangles, attach them together like that so that the machine would cut this part. And I use the gold iron on for that. The buttons, I use circles, very easy, 1.5 inch circles. Go to shapes, add a circle, then I added 2 smaller circles and then just duplicated these. I go to make it, I chose the material Everyday Iron On and I put more pressure for the machine to cut it. For all the iron-ons, there's a flat side and then there's a shiny side. So make sure to put the shiny side down onto the strong grip mat. So this is the black one for the belt. This is the gold one for the buckle, shiny side down. And of course you will cut it to size. Don't want to use the whole piece if you don't need to. And then be careful when you lift it up because it does wrinkle a little bit. This is the brown one for the buttons. Then you can always use the portable trimmer to trim it.
Then you want to take the easy press mat and it'll say this side down. So you turn it that way. Take your t-shirt. I suppose you can put it inside if you want, if you're a little concerned with the table, but it doesn't go through, so I'm just going to keep it this way. And then I measured 7 inches from the bottom of the t-shirt and put this little dot. That's going to be the bottom of the belt. And as I said earlier, I have to do 2 parts for the belt, so I'm going to do this side first. Flatten it out. So I'm going to do the longer piece first. So where the dot is, just cover it a little bit. Go all the way to the edge here. Okay. And then here, the easy press, I've set it to 255 for the black one and 60 seconds. I was also doing 30 seconds, like 3 30 seconds or 90 seconds total. So you can press timer and go down 30 seconds, go up, okay, press timer again, and so it'll be green, so that means it's ready. So just bring it over here from the stand, okay, and then press it, and it's gonna count down. This is so fun. I loved the iron on part of this whole project, and wait till you get to take off the iron on. It's a lot of fun. So this is pressed on already. Then I'll go to this part, and then it's just a matter of doing this 3 times just to get the whole area covered or heated. So you let it cool down, and this is the best part. Pulling it off, it's like butter. I love it. Yes. So make sure to take that part off, and then I'll put the second part, same thing, at 255. Then the buckle fits over that line here, and I just try to put it in the middle of the belt. This one is going to be at 275 for about 2 minutes, so 4 30-second intervals. And then I'll just place the buttons in the middle, and maybe starting an inch above the buckle. Doc, I'm giving him 3 buttons. So it'll just be like that. And of course, just make sure that the iron-on is on the mat. So this is what the shirt looks like now, with the buttons, the belt, and the buckle. I hope you enjoyed this easy DIY last minute Halloween costume making the 7 Dwarfs with Cricut. Happy Halloween! All this time you thought-